for giving young entrepreneurs the platform for the future. Welcome to another exciting episode, eye-opening episode of Hangout with Youth in Agri. I'm Joella Barak. Now, if you are a youth and you are in any of the agri value chain, DM me today so you can have a free, I say it again, a free interview with me on the Hangout with Youth in Agri. Welcome to the show. Welcome back. Today I have on set with me a rabbit farmer, Bolanle Adenuka, aka Daddy's Girl. Now, why that name, Daddy's Girl?
I've always been very close to my dad. I'm not the only child, but people always assume me I'm the only child.
Because of excess love. Yeah, excess. Okay, so me, I'm mommy's girl then. Yeah, so I'm mommy's girl. So now, Bolanle is a rabbit farmer. Can you imagine? Now, look at this rabbit, it's so cute. Bolanle, how can one start this business?
Okay, because this was 10,000 naira.
Wow. So you just need a capital?
Yes,
of
10,000 as little as a veranda or corner, and just get some habits and just put them there.
And you start?
Yes. And the good thing is, you don't have to spend money buying food or stuff if you can't afford it.
Okay.
You can give them vegetables to use as well. Not out raw.
Okay.
Like the lilies, the cabbages, the weju.
Okay.
Yes.
So they eat the food humans can eat?
Yes, they eat leaves.
Okay.
Mostly vegetables. Yes.
Okay.
It's mostly vegetables.
Now, if you are, if someone wants to venture into a rabbit farming, is there a type of rabbit? Is there a special rabbit that one should look out for?
Yeah, there are different breeds of rabbits.
Okay.
And what you want to breed rabbits for? We determine the breeds you are going for.
Okay.
So if you want to keep as pets, some people just keep as pets, just put in the house. You can go for the Angora, the Highlands, and the Dutch. The Dutch are small.
Okay.
So they don't grow big.
Okay.
So you can put them as pets.
Like this one is for what? What is the purpose for this one?
This is a New Zealand buck. You can get this as pets. You can get as mates.
Okay, so you can eat this?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Now imagine someone, he's so cute. So how, why would you want to kill something like this for food?
That's just depending on why you wear rabbits.
Okay.
So if you, some people cannot eat meat, beef, due to health challenges.
Yeah.
So doctors mostly recommend rabbit meat because it has no fat, no cholesterol.
Exactly.
Yes,
yeah, I know that they are very high in protein.
Yes. So, and the good thing is there is no religious barrier to eating rabbit meat. So, some people just prefer to wear and eat at home.
Okay.
Because it is quite scarce. The meat is quite scarce.
Okay.
To get in the market. It's not in everyday market like the chicken or fish.
So, finally, you wear rabbit for sale, right?
Yes.
Okay, so now if you want to, let's check out the market visibility. What are the opportunities of this kind of farm?
Okay, the challenge with rabbit farming is the market mostly.
Okay.
When people come to me, I want to start rabbit farming. I'm interested in getting rabbits. But my problem is, how do I get market for it? And I always tell them, there is market for rabbits. The problem is starting. We don't have enough rabbits in Nigeria as of now.
Okay.
We import mostly from the Benin Republic.
We import rabbits?
Yes, from the Benin Republic, Ghana, as of now. So we can't even meet up with the demand in Nigeria alone. But most people don't know where to sell to. So that's where I come in sometimes. I encourage them to go into it and I tell them, okay, I'll help you get market if you can start.
Okay.
Because I'm always looking for rabbits sometimes. Sometimes I'll get other rabbits in that. So that is a challenge in itself.
Okay. So now, do you think Nigerians consume more rabbits, or is that the reason why the family rabbits thing is not really that common?
Rabbit farming is an emerging market.
Okay.
People are just paying into it. So we don't have enough people doing it commercially.
Okay.
Yes. So we have people doing it, but not commercially enough. That maybe, you know, before you can say you are a rabbit farmer commercially, you must have at least 200 rabbits.
Okay.
Yes. So, but as an most people, maybe 20, then that's still subsistence farming.
Okay.
According to standard of
commercial.
So I would say we don't have enough rabbit meat.
Like this rabbit that you have here.
Yes.
So if you want to sell this rabbit, this goes for how much?
This goes for like 5,000.
Wow. That's huge money. That's huge money.
But if you are buying as meat, it's not that expensive.
Oh, okay. Because so, it has already been processed. Or what?
Not necessarily. I think there's a dynamics to what we do. If you want to buy to rear, that's a breeding stock.
Okay.
We have this I have these things that you look out for in a breeding stock, at least ability to give you good quality meat after breeding.
Okay.
Then the female will be very productive.
Okay. Those are things to look out for.
To look out for. So that makes the price very expensive. Because when my rabbits do that, I have to sort them. Okay, this will make good breed.
Okay.
So the males are mostly what we sell as meat.
Okay. And you the only thing is to keep reproducing.
Yes, because they are mostly just good for mating the females, and that's all.
Okay.
So you can easily keep them as well as meat.
Okay. Now let's talk about the challenges of this farm. I know in areas like zoonotic diseases, those kind of diseases that are transferred from animals to humans. Now, in facing challenges that has to do with rabbit farming, what are these challenges, and what do you think is advisable to be done?
The major diseases that I think rabbit farming has that doesn't have cure right now is your RSV virus.
Okay.
Every other disease is something that if you notice on time, appear mostly.
Okay.
So I can remember when I just started that. And one day I got there and the ears was like something was eating them off, like halfway. And the body, and I was so scared, I was like, oh, this rabbit will die. Oh my god, my rabbit will die.
And all your investment gone.
Exactly. And before I knew it was spreading, because they have this way of spreading diseases.
Okay.
If you don't notice on time.
Okay.
That's always advise people that are doing it on the last scale to have a sick bin.
Okay.
So once you notice early, like check your rabbit every day. Once you notice early, change.
And it's something you can treat them yourself, or you have to take them to a veterinary.
You can do this.
Okay.
If you're doing this commercially in the long run, you learn because getting vets at the long run, the cost implication will be quite high. So you learn over time. But then you're used to it, it's something you can do. So you sort them once you notice of time that okay, this is infected, and you give treatment.
So is it that you run a test for them to know what kind of disease they are, what is their problem?
Yes, just takes the reason. Like your 50 grand home place.
Wow. And you do that yourself. That's good. That's amazing.
Thank you.
Alright, now let's go to technology. How has technology innovations helped rabbit farming in Nigeria?
That, like I said, it's an emerging market. We are hoping for improvement and help from government anyway.
Okay. So are you trying to say that there are presently no technological innovations that has come to help this kind of
farming? From government, no. Most of the time when you say young, some people be like, wow, today is a bit. When I wanted to start, my family was like, this girl, this thing you are investing money on, who will buy it from you? You just like wahala. And I'll be like, don't worry, my customers are in Nigeria. And they'll be like, and most of the time when I go home with this basket or sometimes that carton, and people will be like, wow, rabbits. Do people get this thing? It's strange. So it's something that people don't really know about yet.
Okay.
But I think maybe with time, government will come to realize that it is something that is very important to
And what are the suggestions that you have to give to them?
Maybe if you can help us with planning importation of rabbits to help the local farmers
produce more.
Okay. Now people prefer to go and buy than to produce to get what they have and multiply because they feel it is cheaper to buy abroad than local. Then we don't even have more breeding stock. We just circle what we have, and over time the quality drops. Like the Hyla Max, the Hyla line in Nigeria, the mixture of the California White. California White is an imported breed,
okay. And
the New Zealand White. The New Zealand White is our local white breed. So we mix them together to get the Hyla, and wow, it looks beautiful. White, black hairs, black nose. It takes the features of goats, but over time the quality drops, and the California White traits in it begins to reduce and they look more like New Zealand White again. So I think we can do more with producing more California White, okay, and not mix with New Zealand White.
Okay.
So to improve the quality. And the reason why is that the California White has more meat value compared to this. They go big faster over time. Okay. It's just like the broiler chicken.
Okay.
So I think we need more parent stock of those in Nigeria to boost the industry.
And we need them to circulate the market.
Yes.
Okay, let's take a short break. When we come back, we'll continue the show. But then it's still on set, so don't go anywhere. Welcome back. It's still a hangout with you in Agric on Agri Business Weekend. And I'm so sure that so many of you are wondering, this rabbit family that we are even talking about, where is the rabbit? Or probably it's one imaginary object. Bola, tell them that there's a rabbit here.
Yeah.
There is. Can you bring it out?
Sure.
I mean, wow, he looks so cute. Hope it doesn't bite.
No.
Now, do you know that rabbits are a great source of fur? Fur are animal skin materials, and they look at the skin. Just imagine you want to wear this as a pet. As a pet in your house. So, and you can eat this too.
Yes.
Oh. So somebody's gonna buy this someday and eat this someday.
Yes.
I've already cried, but never
exactly this. To jump off.
Okay. Now, if you are thinking of starting a livestock business, think of rabbit farming. Imagine you sell this for 5,000 naira and you really do not have to go through any stress. It is less capital intensive, and it is used for different purposes. People can buy from you as a pet, people can buy from you as meat, people can buy from you as a great source of, like I said, fur. Well done, Bola.
Thank you.
I must say you're doing a great job.
Thank you.
And we hope that the Nigerian market is open for more of this.
Yes.
Now, if you are a youth out there and you practice any of the agri value chain, DM me today, contact me today, so you can have a free interview with me on a hangout with youth in agri. But remember, you must be following us on all our social media platforms, and you should have subscribed to our Agribusiness Weekend YouTube channel. So you see that red button over there, subscribe. Till I come your way next time, we are giving agripreneurs the platform for the future. From I and Bola today, it's bye for now.